cookie. And that was Ducky Lucky Ducky. All right, this is a best off to a Josh Gear Sanctuary. Basically, this is my winter and summer vest off. I'm gonna put all my gear and I'm going to use it, and then I'm gonna do an overnighter. Unload! Leave me alone. So I'm gonna do an overnighter with my gear, see how it works. Remember, it's gonna be a little cold tonight, so I brought my bed padding and my sleeping bag, because it's gonna be cold tonight. So let's go ahead and enjoy this video. All right, I'm gonna take my gear off. If I can. This is my bedroll, my chair, and my sleeping bag. This is my hat. I don't need it right now. All right, we got my cup that goes in this little cubby hole over here. I'm wearing two vests because this is my backpack vest, and I have everything I need. Y'all know what this pack is all about. Let me show you what this pack is all about. This is my summer pack. I have a canteen here, another canteen, and I'm going to show you what's in this pack. So come on with me real quick. I want to show you what's in. I want to go over here in the shade, because it's going to be shady. There's a nice pretty shade over there. And I want to show you what's in this bag. This bag is my survival bag. I can get good water with this pouch. Basically, this is my water vest. So let's take a look what's in the summer vest. Look at me! Look at me! Damn you, boy! All right. This one's a little harder to take off because I need it closer so I can put the other vest on. Alright, what does this vest contain? Let's find out. Alright, Josh, you beat me with the homemade vest. Let's see if you can got me now. Alright, let's take a look. What's in the summer vest? Okay, we got... Basically, this is for getting water and containing water, because it's summer now and you need plenty of water. We got that. It's also good for cooking. I got a little string in case I need it. I got two of them. And the bottom, I have my fishing kit, the handicapper. I won his prize, and that's one of them. That's the handicapper. I got my fishing pole, which is a little cane, bamboo. I'm sorry. I got some hooks and goodies in here. This weighs lighter and stronger than a PVC pipe. So I'm gonna show you my fishing kit, and I'm gonna show you how I use my fishing kit. And my rod and reel's in the damn car. All right. Over here, I have this. You know, like, what the hell is that for, Ranger Kooky? Well, if I find two cans, I get sipping water. All right. I have the soya filter system. I have a small bag to carry the soya filter system, so I can just carry this with me instead of all my gear. over here is an empty pouch. Y'all seen this, y'all know what this is. This is my little radio. And here, I got two little drop lines with a hook on it, so I can fish with catfish. Here I got my trout line. Some people call this bait line, I call it a trout line because it says it on the bag, trout line. And here I have my food rations. This is enough food for 2 days. Well, for me. But if you really portion it, this is almost like 5 days worth of food in this pouch. That's about it. That's all the pouches on this bag. I hope you enjoy. And a little flint, in case I need it. I hope you enjoy my summer vest. Now I'm gonna show you what's in the other vest. I'm gonna hook it all up for you. So stay tuned for that. Look at those ducks. All right, so let's go take a look in the other vest. What's all hooked up? No coffee. It's all right. All right, now we're gonna go through this vest. What's in this vest, Ranger Kooky? Well, let's find out. In this vest, I carry a tarp. I also have hammock. In the hammock, I have a. Let's see what I got in there. I have 550 cord, and what I did is tie loop knots in every 5 inches to make this weird-looking chain knot. And I'm gonna show you how I use that. First, you find you. A guinea pig tree. Come closer, watch me. On a guinea pig tree, you take your hammock and place it in those knots that you have made in your 550 cord, and the knots, if you had to go further, you could got knots all the way to here to here. All right, test your hammock, make sure your hammock is wide enough for you, make sure it's not too high. I'm not a giant. You're not watching me. There you go. Right there. Now you can watch me. Alright, before you go to bed, make sure you test your hammock and make sure it's not going nowhere. There you go. Let's get your tarp up. All right, on my vest, I have right here 550 cord. So get your 550 cord out for your tarp. Come down. Shut up, I'm making a video. Now what you want to do, you want to go over the rope that you put to your hand. And I usually put a little loop knot here. And take this, go through like this, pull it tight, then take and loop it again. That's not going nowhere. Now, then you take your hammock, your shirt. Damn you, boy! Now, only thing I don't have is pins, because pins are heavy to carry. I might put something in there. All right, what we're looking for is... See, I need to invest some bobby pins or something. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. You have a good time till the weather blows your shit around. I need to invest in some stakes here. Alright, all depends on this which side you want your tarp. You want your tarp to go on this side, or I'm gonna face the lake. So I'm gonna face the lake. So I have to bring this all the way down. It's a temporary tarp too. It's not something to. It's not. This tarp is not good for weeks. This is only good for a couple of days because the weather will destroy your stuff. I need some sticks, damn you, boy. So I'm gonna try the diamond. I very, very rarely use the diamond in anything. So I'll go ahead and try the diamond shape. Because it's not a temporary stay. It's like when I go camping with my Molly, I'm there for a week or 2 weeks when I go camping with my Molly too. There's a couple reasons why I don't like the diamond shape. It's not good for protection. I mean, it's temporary protection, but when you got the square, it protects you more. But this is just a vest to get out and go do something. Alright, get another 550 cord. Now what we do is stake one side of the, we'll try to tie this up. I have to try that method that Grumpy taught me. Hey, see, this won't be a mess if I did it like Grumpy. Damn that man. Well, hello there. I'm Ranger Cookie. And I want to do a little test to see what lights better than normal wood. I got some fat wood. I'm shaving it. Look, I grabbed. Well, look who I grabbed the shaved fat wood with. Oh my goodness. So I'm going to shave some fat wood. And what happens if you went into a park like I am today, where you can't not find no fat wood or fat lighter? So you have to find what you can find. So I found this. This is a piece of dry piece of wood. And I found some, what you call it, some fungus that grows on the oak tree. I don't know what that is. So I'm going to do some tests with different items and see which one lights the best. We know fat wood is going to catch on fire like hell. But how about the rest of the stuff that we could find? I can go out and find some turkey feathers. We know, look at that big fat whatever fungi. I wonder if that'll light. So far I've never seen nobody use the fungi that grows on these unless I'm mistaken, I could be wrong. So I'm going to do a test with the fungi that grows on the oak. Kind of hard to work an unstable table. Yeah. All right, let's see if it's a, is it the handler doing it or is the fungus? Let's try the fat wood now. I know it's gonna light just to make sure I'm not doing it wrong. Yep, it's the fungi. It's not kicking. It just cooked, just caught on fire. So that's working. I'm doing it right. So it's the fungi. It's not doing what I think it will. Alright, let's try. Let's move our fat wood. Let's try the, this is an old pond. And I just try to mash it up. Piece of dried piece of pond. So let's see if we can light that up. There it goes. So that lit up pretty good. All right, so we got the pine needles. We found pine needles everywhere, so let's see what happens if we can light pine needles. This dry stuff light up. The fat wood we know is gonna light up, but let's try pine needles. I heard you gotta crush it up really good. It's like straw, like a straw bin. If you got a lot of straw in the bin, you light one match, you going up. Let's take a look at that. That's not working. And the last thing we always find in the woods is the bark. So we're going to crush that up and see if we can get that light up. But the combination of the fat wood that I have here and the material I have, I should start a fire real good, but I just want to see what happens if you just had this. It's just going to be rare if you just to have one item in the woods. I don't think that's going to light up. All right, like I said, I love testing trials, so you don't have to. So let's find out. It's not working. So a combination of fat wood and old bark. All right, now we got a combination of old wood with fat lighter. We know that's gonna catch. It's like a feather stick. I could have ducked tonight. Come on. There, we got a little fire. I forgot to grab the twigs. Camping while the campfire is not camping, they say. I'm Ranger Cookie. I hope you enjoy my video of starting a campfire for the night. Bye bye! Look at this fire I got going on here. You can't beat a campfire. Now I just need some bacon. Well, I don't eat bacon. We're gonna build this fire too pretty good. You know what burns really good? Pine cones. You ever see a pine cone burn before? Might catch the woods on fire. All right, buddy. This is a shout out to Donnie Paolini and Cole Craven. They want to see a long video, so here it is. I got my camp gear right behind me, and I'm enjoying this view. Take a look where I'm at. All right, there you go, Cole Craven and Donnie Paolini. I'm out here at Area Lake enjoying a nice fire and learn. All right, I'm Ranger Cookie. Now see you next video. Give you boy. I don't want to be out here alone. I want to have somebody here with me. Oh well, I can do it. Bye bye. Well, I'm back. I just want to show you this nice little campfire I made earlier. And it's still going on right now. I just want to show you the flames. Hear the coals on this baby. Come see. Come see. Man, I wish I brought me some mashed potatoes to throw in there. Oh, not mashed potatoes. Listen to me, a potato. Roll it up in some aluminum foil. Put it in that flame. Look at that. I hope it doesn't melt my camera. I just wanted to show you that. Nice little flame I got. I hope no moths goes in there and dies. Alright, I'm Ranger Cookie. I just want to put this in my video and show you my campfire at night. Alright, see our next video. What's to turn off? Damn you. Well, I'm Ranger Cookie. And I wanted to show you something. When you're out here at some type of place where you can find food, I got some food. Yeah! And he's running away from me. Get back to me before I'm hungry. I'm sorry, but my food ran away from me. Oh, shit. Alright, I read your cookie. I just want to show you Mr. Toad. He's gonna say, Happy Supper Day!